What's up there, guys? Thanks for tuning in. This is my third and final installment of my Tamiya Panzer IV Type G kinda new kit. In this video, you're gonna see me do some oil work. You're gonna see me do some chipping. You're gonna see me do some jerry can work. You're gonna see how I paint faces. And last but not least, you're gonna see me work on a muffler. Thanks for tuning in. I hope you enjoy. Now, I always look over the tank to see where is the best place to put the oil paint for highlighting and for shadows. So at first, I pick a place I could just test it. And here I'm putting it in the spot behind where the spare road wheel would be placed, just to test it to see how it would look once, completed. So here I am dabbing the white oil paint after I laid it out. Once I like the look, then I continue and do the rest of the superstructure. Once I did the entire side with the white color, then I proceeded to mix yellow ochre with raw umber, and I proceeded then to do the shadows. Usually I would do the shadows in the lower part of the superstructure, underneath, tools and so forth. It's to add contrast, to make the tank look, visually more interesting. And the procedure is pretty much the same. You lay out the oil paint, you move it around to where you'd like it, then you dab it to blend it. And you may have to go over it a couple of times, because usually if you look at the video, you'll see I'll go over it a couple of times to get the desired look. And even after a couple hours, I may go back and do it again.
Thank you.
This color is my favorite chipping color. And I also realized that the smaller the sponge I use for chipping, the better the chips come out. And it's a fine combination of knowing when to press a little hard and knowing when not to. So I like to start off with the hatches, especially on this tank, because the hatches are going to be covered up mostly by the crew. So I want to see, I'm testing it, you know, to see how it's going to come out. And then once I like the look and I know the, you know, the procedure works, the technique works, then I'll apply it to the rest of the tank. So I'm using dry earth to simulate dust and, I guess, sand for the lower part of the hull. I love this. This is a wonderful product, a fantastic product. Just make sure to shake it a lot, vigorously, rigorously. And also, after shaking, I like to stir it up at the bottom because all the sediment and, I guess, the pigment and the texture is at the bottom, so you gotta mix it up. Thank you. All right, I guess that's it. I'm done. I'm calling this one finito. Again, thank you for watching. I appreciate it. This tank was a fun build. It was very fun also to do the figures. I have not built a tank with the crew on it in a very long time. So it was wonderful just to see, you know, how far my skills have decayed, and they have. They have declined significantly when it comes to figure painting. But, you know, I got a little bit of that bug back again to start, you know, building and painting figures. Again, I hope you enjoyed the video. If you have any questions, any comments, please, you know, leave it in the space provided below. Have a great one, guys. Girls, be good. Brucca-NYC out.